A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th Feb, on the front page you have, "Will stand by decision on Article 370 Citizenship Amendment Act, Modi." So Prime Minister says that these decisions were necessary in national interest, and despite widespread protests, these decisions will not be revoked. Then below you have, "Video of police brutality in Jamia library goes viral." So, uniformed men are seen in this viral video raining blows on students. So, this was in the context of Citizenship Amendment Act protests. So, following protests against Citizenship Amendment Act, armed men entered university library and assaulted students studying there. On page 2, you have, "Encroachment of MP National Park land continues unchecked." So, Madhav National Park. A national park in Madhya Pradesh has claimed denotified land is unavailable for allotment to 39 tribal families displaced 20 years ago to make way for a tiger corridor. Even though hundreds of others compensated for to vacate the park continue to farm and encroach upon the corridor unchecked. So they were asked to vacate, they did not vacate, and the corridor as such is continued to be used by them as well. This you can see families displaced are staging a dharna at Shivpuri Collectorate. Also, Madhav National Park has no tigers yet. So, tigers are yet to be reintroduced in the park, let alone the corridor's development. So, requirement of a corridor would come later. So, this is the scenario. On page 8, you have, "Wayanad Tiger Reserve proposal fails to find favor." So, this is in Kerala, Wayanad Tiger Reserve. So, Chief Minister of Kerala Pinarayi refers to public protests and human wildlife conflicts in the district as the reason that the Wayanad Wildlife Sanctuary will not be designated or notified as a tiger reserve. It says, the CM says it lacks public support. So, you can see the tiger population in Wayanad is around 75 to 80. Periyar Tiger Reserves have 30 to 35 tigers. It's a tiger reserve. Another one from Kerala is Parambikulam Tiger Reserve. That also has around 20 to 25. While Wayanad has 75 to 80, but CM says there is no public support. Human wildlife conflict is prevalent. So, Wayanad Tiger Reserve will not be declared so. It will remain only a wildlife sanctuary. It will not be given the designation of a tiger reserve. Below you have, ISRO making preparations to launch GSAT-1 in March. So, Indian Space Research Organization is preparing to launch GSAT-1, which is a new Earth observation satellite. It's called geo-imaging satellite. So, it will be the first of two planned Indian Earth observation spacecrafts to be placed in geostationary orbit of around 36,000 km. Then, on page 9 you have, Madhya Pradesh grapples with spiraling neonatal deaths. So, in Madhya Pradesh, there is a staff crunch, low community referrals, and these are the major factors as such which have resulted in spiraling neonatal deaths, infants dying. In the last 3 years, more than 7% of the babies admitted to sick newborn care units across 13 states have died. So, here you can see how states fare is shown here. Admissions, number of admissions in thousands is shown here, and this is percentage of deaths against total admissions. You can see that is very high for Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, so on. Then below you have COVID-19, that is coronavirus 19. India reaches out to China. So India is ready to send consignment of medical supplies to China to deal with coronavirus. So, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had also extended a helping hand to China, and now this medical supplies consignment would be sent. Then below you have, India inks 14 MOUs with Russia for defense support spares. So, these MOUs cover modern T-90 tanks, Pechora air defense systems, etc. So, there are 14 MOUs with respect to defense support which we have signed with Russia. On the editorial page, the first editorial is perverse zeal. So, this is regarding National Security Act being slapped against Dr. Kafil Khan. So, and he has been detained. So, this misuse of National Security Act to suppress political dissent and the allegation against him is that he was going to give speeches which would invoke protests or something. So this such misuse of National Security Act to suppress political dissent, they said, is a blot on India's democratic credentials. So we have discussed about Dr. Kafil Khan. He was the one who was booked, had become the scapegoat in the Gorakhpur Medical College Hospital case in which 60 children had died in 2017. So the inquiry committee was set up and it showed that he had no role to play, and he was absolved from the charges of negligence and corruption. But the state government said that this is not the clean sheet given by the government. It's the report of the inquiry committee which the government should accept. If we don't accept, then he's not given a clean sheet. So the government continued to, you know, target him, and now when he is participating in Anti-Citizenship Amendment Act protests, he has been charged with National Security Act provisions and has been detained. So this is done by Uttar Pradesh government under Yogi Adityanath. Then this is Delhi at the center. So this is regarding how Delhi has seen AAP getting a third consecutive term, and now it says Kejriwal must now work within his mandate and the center should not stall him. So he's got another 5-year term. The lead article is China, the media and truth telling in a crisis. So this is regarding the new coronavirus issue in China. It started from Wuhan, but then the news did not come out till the situation aggravated. The authorities suppressed the news till they realized that it is gone out of control. So Wuhan has shown that when given the space to work, Chinese journalists can play a much needed watchdog role. So the media in China has been playing a significant role now, and truth telling in a crisis is happening. So that is appreciated here. And below you have, in political micro-targeting, the vulnerable Indian voter. So this is regarding the Indian voter. How does an Indian voter vote? How electoral process functions? So, data protection framework, which is there, should uphold voters' information autonomy too. So, now these days, like Facebook, etc., are used for micro-targeting voters, which we have seen in US presidential elections too. The whole detail had come out. So, such cases can be there in India as well. So, our informational autonomy of voters is important. So, that should be within the framework of data protection laws. On op-ed page, you have museums without meaning. So this is in the context of the budget announcement that 5 museums would be state-of-the-art museums, of international standards would be established in Chennai, Delhi, Kolkata, Hyderabad and Srinagar. So this proposal is looked with skepticism. It says recent declarations regarding preservation of India's heritage leave many questions unanswered. Like, where will these museums be established? Where would land be? What objects will it display? How will it source them? Who will staff these museums, etc.? So it gives an example of how recently the museum which has been established in Rajkot in Gujarat, which is Watson Museum. So it holds intricate histories of colonial Saurashtra, but artifacts here are having dust settling on them. And below you have an unclear revamp. So this is regarding recent news of restructuring of the Ministry of External Affairs to effectively empower 7 different additional secretaries and reorganize their tasks among themes as such. So here the article says that there is no clarity on whether the recent restructuring aligns with India's strategic goals. So identifying areas of long-term impact as such is important. So the missing piece in the restructuring is silence on the role of public policy and research development, research division, now headed by an outstanding officer. So it was central in an earlier round of restructuring with inclusion of military officials and consultants from academia and think tanks. So questions have been raised on how the rearrangement restructuring is being done in Ministry of External Affairs. On page 12 you have, India rejects Qatar's mediation offer. So this is UN Secretary General who has made the latest offer, Antonio Guterres, to mediate between India and Pakistan on the Kashmir issue, saying that it would only discuss the matter bilaterally. But India has rejected this offer. And this is poll panel working on remote voting system. So IIT Madras is providing this technology to Election Commission. So a model of an Aadhaar linked electronic voting system, which will enable electors to cast their votes from any part of the country, irrespective of where they are registered to vote or even abroad. So this has been prepared for the Election Commission of India by IIT Madras. On international page, you have multiple rockets hit US coalition base in Baghdad. So this is, you can see an Iraqi base hosting American troops near US embassy have been attacked by multiple rockets. So attack on US assets in Iran continue, on Iraq, in Iraq continue. Then this is airstrike kills 31 civilians in Yemen. So Yemen's Iran aligned Houthi movement has accused Saudi-led coalition of carrying out retaliatory airstrikes that killed at least 30 people, including civilians. So, this is the conflict which is going on in Yemen, with Yemeni government supported by Saudi Arabia on one side and the Houthi rebels supported by Iran on the other side. Then, on Monday's business page has this money-wise coverage in which individual money and investment related issues are picked up, which are not important. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.